In our animation and games art degree show, this year's cohort, they've got a broad range of skill and ability. A number of students have produced 2D animation. It could be either traditional animation, it could be digital 2D animation, it could be After Effects, VR, various game engines. A number of students have produced 3D animation, and that's been produced within Maya. Or they've maybe pushed it a little further and they've created their own rigs and they've done a lot of compositing within After Effects.
My animated piece is called Duncan, and it was a short film about a man and his quest for milk. I did combine 3D animation with 2D. I used the 3D character. Sometimes the sets were 3D, sometimes they were 2D. For example, in the film, he is climbing a 3D cliff. There was no potential way to do it in 2D with it getting the same stylized look and look like he's legitimately interfacing with a cliff as opposed to a 2D plate on putting in After Effects.
I think the most helpful part of the whole course, for me at least, because I'm a 2D-based animator, was a lot of life drawing, and we just had the time and the ability to just look at how anatomy works and what wraps around what to make what move, which is really essential when you're trying to put that on paper.
I think it's important to exhibit different people's work because it then gives the younger generation, who potentially don't have the access to the software that we use or the resources that we have to use, it gives them something to come and look at and be inspired by, so then they can begin their journey.
If you want to become an animator, with university, you really need to put in as much of yourself into it to get the most out of it.